The city's first new contemporary public art space in 20 years opened this October at the University of Brighton. Based across two galleries and a 270-seat theatre in the University of Brighton's Grand Parade building, Brighton CCA will place the resources of the university, including its research and archives, at the disposal of artists and make those accessible to its students and the wider public through a combination of commissioned work, public events, and practice-based research projects. The inaugural programme featured the sculpture work of Franz Heather Walter and its first UK presentation in over 7 years, alongside a performance installation by Dog Kennel Hill Project, a London-based collective fusing dance, film, sculpture and performance. I spoke with the Brighton CCA Artistic Director, Ben Roberts, to find out more.
There are arts organisations, obviously, in the city, but for whatever reason it happens to be, there wasn't a... contemporary art programme in these spaces as part of the university, and I think the university had recognised that that was perhaps something that they wanted to rectify and something that could really contribute to the city. I think there's also a great deal of provision across the South Coast in terms of contemporary visual art spaces. If you think of, you know, Towner and De La War and Hastings Contemporary and Margate and, you know, all of these places, there's a lot of galleries there, and they're quite white cubed spaces, sort of museological in that sort of sense. And I think what we're trying to do here is something very different from that. It's not about trying to be a museum, it's about responding to our context, being part of a university and an art school. So this is a place where experimentation happens, it's about process, it's about making, and it's about providing ways for people to come and get involved in the creative process in that way and seeing how artists work. So the show that you can see behind me, the Dog Kennel Hill Project, are a collective from South London, and they're using this gallery partly as their first UK retrospective of 15 years worth of their practice is available for people to see here, but they're also using the space as a studio. So they are making new work here, they are asking visitors to come and participate in some of their performances, and they are presenting a series of talks and other events about the ideas that inform their work. So there's a real sense that you can actually see the work, how it's made, and be involved in its production at the same time. Part of what we're doing here is to be outward facing for the university and to let people know about all the exciting research and projects that are going on here. There's a great deal of exciting research that informs a lot of what artists are interested in. Artists aren't just interested in making a painting or a sculpture or a film. They're interested in what's going on in the world, and the university similarly is about researching some of those really key things, so things like climate change. The university is very clear, and I'm very clear, that we want to use this programme and use Brighton CCA as an opportunity to bring some of that research out into the public, but also to make it available to artists to inform their work, to help them to make new work. So there's, I think, a real important collaboration, if you like, between artists in creative practice and the wider work of the university, and Brighton CCA is about being a hub for enabling that to happen.
Where do you see contemporary art going from this point?
I think there's, as with so many things at the moment, there's a bit of a polarisation. You know, a lot of people see contemporary art as being something that's just for sale, shiny objects, huge prices, you know, all this sort of stuff. But for me, that's not where the power of contemporary art is, and I think that's not what any artist thinks of it as being at, really. I think in a society where views and discourse is increasingly sort of black and white, yes or no, with us or against us, art is one of those few places where there is space for a bit of discourse, a bit of discourse, a bit of discussion, nuance, and grey areas, if you like. And places like galleries and theatres, such as we have here, are the places where people can come and engage in those discussions. It's where that lives, and I think that's something to be really cherished. Contemporary art is a space for experimentation, finding things out, being able to get things wrong, and accepting the possibility of different views in one space. So I think, actually, when you look at it, these spaces, these artists, these are the places where the ideas that inform our society, that solve our problems, that address the things that we're all worried about, this is where those ideas come from, and that's what contemporary art is all about. So in terms of the future programme, There's a lot going on in the coming few weeks. So our programme runs over the course of the year. So we have about 5 exhibition slots per year. And after these 2 exhibitions, we've got a really exciting new project with an artist called Giles Round. It's the first of an annual collaboration with the Design Archives, which are held here at Brighton. They began from the UK Design Archives being gifted to the university. And when that happened, a whole bunch of other designers and makers started giving us their estates. So they're all looked after here downstairs underneath the art school. And we have a series of archivists who are working there looking after that work. So we're inviting artists and designers to come to the university to spend 6 months in the archives looking at the various materials we got there and using that as a starting point for a commission to make an exhibition of new work of their own, which also shows and showcases work from the design archives. So Giles has been doing that research and is coming here to install his show in January. His father was a lighting engineer, used to work for the London Electricity Board, and he's drawing on some of that personal history and some of the lighting design material that we've got in the archive, of which there's a great deal actually, to make a show which is really about the history of lighting design, history of display design as well. So he's going to be setting up in this space, he'll be setting up a sort of makeshift studio where he will be producing a whole series of lights and different sculptures that will move into the gallery next door as part of his show. He'll be making the lights in here, printing images from the archive onto them, so it'll be a way of representing the material that we have downstairs as part of the exhibition. So that's going to be a really exciting project. Following that, we're going to be putting on a summer school for artists over the course of the summer, which is a super exciting collaboration that we have with a local charity called Outside In, who are working with people who may face barriers to participation in culture. We're running a whole series of workshops with them about how you can be a professional artist, how you can write about your work, put together your portfolio, how you would approach a gallery, how you can talk to museums and galleries about getting shows. Lots of practical advice for people who are interested in knowing more about being an artist and how art galleries work.